Ain't got no home, ain't got no shoes, ain't got no money, ain't got no class, ain't got no skirts, ain't got no sweaters, ain't got no perfume, ain't got no love, ain't got no faith. I ain't got no culture, ain't got no mother, ain't got no father, ain't got no brother, ain't got no children.
An artist's duty, as far as I'm concerned, is to reflect the times. I think that is true of painters, sculptors, poets, musicians. It's as far as I'm concerned, it's their choice. But I choose to reflect the times and the situations in which I find myself. That to me is my duty. And at this crucial time in our lives, when everything is so desperate, when every day is a matter of survival, I don't think you can help but be in love.
So when I come, I feel a responsibility. They're so glad to see me because I represent something to them. And I can't give them enough, you know. They need me. They need me. And when I'm needed, I have to give. And the most important thing is they are our future. It's an investment as far as I am concerned.
And what have I got?
Thank you so much.
I wrestle with an alligator. That's right. I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
I'm going to fight for the prestige, not for me, but to uplift my little brother.
For what? They never called me nigger. They never lynched me. They didn't put no dogs on me. They didn't rob me of my nationality, rape and kill my mother.
We need somebody in the world to help us make peace. I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee.
The more things change, the more we have to change with them in order to adjust ourselves and to adjust the message that we're trying to do.
Because like being influenced by the kind of poetry that we were all introduced to, people feel as though like the way to be poetic is to make sure that there's certain little parts of it can't nobody understand.
But this poetry was always put down as street poetry because, of course, that's where the people were. People were on the street, and these were the people that you wanted to communicate with.
So the idea became not only to use ideas that were familiar to people in the community, but to use the language that everybody could understand.
We use it to communicate ideas that we think are things people need to know.
The first change that takes place is in your mind. You have to change your mind before you change the way you live and the way you move.
You have to be a leader. So you mix in. What are we looking at? What do you think we're looking at? We're looking for the best qualities in humanity.
Where your mind is how you build your life. If you put it in fear, if you put it in failure, it works. You know, doubt works.
To a human being who's in a brutal world, un mundo brutal, who's looking to get, tengo sed, beauty, I feel better. I want to be as beautiful, I want to be as honest, I want to be as fearless, I want to be as kind. Do you understand me? That's what we're looking for.
Why am I so insistent upon giving out to them that blackness, that black power, that black pushing them to identify with
black Americans have been the only real diehard Americans here, because we're the only ones who carried the process through the process, that everyone else has sort of like skipped stages. We're the ones who marched, we're the ones who carried the Bible, we're the ones who carried the flag, we're the ones who tried to go through the courts. Being born American didn't seem to matter, because we were born Americans, but we still had to fight for what we were looking for.
So I'd like to do all I can to uplift the people morally and spiritually, and as far as loving self and sticking together and helping self, I'd like to
create a place that's welcoming, that has no hierarchy, no snobbery, that the doors are open and the people at the desk are friendly and say, come in.